Recently, NASA told the world that one of their satellites caught the beams of light of a star being torn apart by a black hole. Since then, pictures from the Hubble Space Telescope have been published, showing the glow from the energy released as the star was tugged at and ripped by the gravity from the black hole, shining at its brightest with 1 trillion times the sun's brightness. The star in question was 3.8 billion light years away when it met with its somewhat violent and brilliant demise. But light years are more than a measure of distance. They're also a measure of time, telling us how far light travels in 1 year. What this means is that the light from that event, from the end of that star as it was pulled to pieces, took about 4 billion years to reach us. That explosion we're seeing now, that happened when the Earth was still in its infancy. There's something eternally striking about realising that when events like this happen, we don't see it immediately. And in fact, at that point in time, there was no one around to see it. This tiny blue marble, hurtling around a yellow dwarf star in the backwater regions of the Milky Way galaxy, was formed only some 4.5 billion years ago, when that aforementioned star, captured by the black hole, sent forth its luminous radiation, the only beacons of its abrupt end. On Earth, simple cells, the first variety of life, were just forming. In between that time and now, life has evolved from very simple, very humble origins to complex and diverse forms, some of which no longer exist, with many more that changed and adapted to life on our world, and even a huge number that we've yet to understand or even discover. Our species, humanity, is so young on the cosmic scale. Our planet, for that matter, is incredibly young on the cosmic scale. Yet, that it could somehow produce a life form that looks around, that stares at the smallest specks and at the vastest reaches, and tries to find understanding and knowledge. And sometimes, when you gaze up into the night sky, you see the traces of that search for knowledge. Satellites meander overhead, floating by almost lackadaisically, feeding information back to the ground about what's around us, what's out there, and what's happening down here. It's only been within the last 50 odd years that we've started putting things in space. For a long time, we could only imagine what was out there. We imagined that one day, we might travel beyond the boundaries of Earth and sky, into the darkness of space, to the moon, and beyond. But it's only been within the last half century that we've soared forth to orbit and to the moon, and sent numerous other craft onward to investigate where, as of yet, we still cannot. And now and then, the endeavours of our all-too-human curiosity allows us to see things and, with careful study, to start to understand what happened and why, to understand how things work, and to realise the splendour, and perhaps slightly terrifying power, of the universe. Such as seeing the light of a star, as it was brought to a fiery annihilation from wandering too close to a black hole, billions of years before we were even a twinkle in our ancestors' eyes.